First day back to school for Emma.
Yes,
great day.
A lot of people. Yeah, looks like a lot of people having no problems as far as weather
goes
this morning. Yeah, it looks good. Could be a little different story tomorrow. We are expecting the possibility of some showers in the morning. So drop off, maybe a little wet in some areas, but I think most areas will be okay. So good news on that front. But, you know, this time of year, you're going to be dodging some storms. This one was late last night and a great lightning show. It's called an anvil crawler. What it is the storm is weakening, doesn't have enough energy for the lightning bolt to travel down through the air and get to the ground, so it just goes along the storm. And what a beautiful shot that was from Damon Powers. Appreciate that. And this one from Matthew A. Smith, Mass Photo Art from Lido. Get a look at that shot. That's amazing, too. Just a spectacular lightning shots that have been taken around the Sun Coast over the last few years have been really quite impressive. Here's the Van Wezel webcam showing some high clouds around, but not a lot of rainfall here near the Ringling Bridge or out over Sarasota Bay. We had some rain in downtown Sarasota, but it was very light, and the airport picked up a little bit of rainfall. But this upper level low continues to spin here, and it's in a counterclockwise fashion. We also have a surface low, and it looks like the surface low is going to head off north toward Georgia while the upper low heads to the southwest. And what that means for us is we're just going to see an increase in moisture availability for these storms, and that means a little heavier rainfall anticipated. And you can see the beginning of that rain, at least the moisture supply is a little bit stronger east of I-75. And this is marching basically to the south and southwest. So it's going to stay off the coast, but it could generate other showers as a result of the outflow boundaries created by that intense line of showers. Now some thunderstorms, too, developing west of Wachula. Not much going on here, but here's a review. Look at this. We had some rain earlier that moved through I-75 and State Road 64. Then it went through, and then it kind of faded away as it headed toward the drier air in the upper levels of the atmosphere, which is located pretty much over the top of the coastal communities and heading out into the Gulf. But the tropical moisture is still right there over central Florida and to the east of Florida. 82 degrees now, so that rain cooled things down at the airport quite nicely. The dew point, though, way up there, 77 degrees. Winds out of the north-northwest at 3, and the high today was 1 degree above average. The low this morning was at 77. Well, as far as the rainfall goes, it fell before they actually measured it at the airport, so it's not indicating any right now, but they only saw about a tenth of an inch there for the most part. 87 in Jacksonville, 89 in Orlando now, and 82 in Key West. Partly cloudy skies tomorrow for most areas. I mentioned there's a chance for a few coastal showers along the west coast of Florida, and then inland areas mainly in the afternoon, but that could be almost anywhere as a result of the light wind flow. So we're looking for light wind flow tomorrow, and it should not mean the storms aren't going to move all that much. It could cause some problems with flooding. Franklin all but gone now, just the remnants, and we have another system we're watching just to the east of Puerto Rico. You can see it not organizing very much. In fact, the Hurricane Center dropping its chances down to 40%. They had been in size 50% yesterday. But still, the thinking is off to the northwest and then to the northeast, staying away from the U.S. Bears watching, though. It never gets that close. Things can change, but it's unlikely it's going to have a huge impact. There's the low pressure area kind of heading off toward Georgia. For us, showers and storms around scattered about at any time during the day, but as I mentioned, there could be even some morning storms in the mix. Here's the forecast for boaters tomorrow. Light chop out there, seas running less than 2 feet, and the water temperature is steaming, 91 degrees. The UV index will be high to 10. The forecast, the tides, low tide at 10:09 and a high at 3:35, another low tide at 9:51. Sunset at 8:12. The forecast, scattered showers, a few storms, up until midnight, really 78 for a low. Tomorrow, a high of 91, 40% chance for rainfall at any time. And then rain chances increasing anywhere from 50 to 60% on Monday and Tuesday of next week. Back to you. Mm-hmm.